Today, we're going to show you how to insert cedars and remove them.
There's only a few tools needed for this process. First and foremost, a cedar applicator. Secondly, an easy breed cedar. And third, some type of cutting device like a pair of pliers.
We recommend cutting the ball off the cedar tail to prevent ewes from pulling the cedar out with their teeth and from catching the tail on the wool of other ewes when grouped together. Some clients will paint the end of the tail a bright color so it is easier to see when they are checking for cedars. An important step in the process is always disinfecting your cedar applicator before each use. We like to use a water betadine solution that has a tea-like color. Now that the cedar applicator has been fully disinfected, we're now going to actually insert the cedar itself. We're going to do this with the tail end of it first, slowly inserting it in and folding in the wings and slowly pushing it forward. Now it's important to notice that when we insert this into the ewe and pull the trigger, that the wings will fold out horizontally to ensure that it won't come out. Our cedar applicator is loaded and we're ready to insert the cedar into the ewe. The betadine solution that we have here today will actually act as a lubricant for us. However, you can also use an additional lubricant, but we ask you to do it sparingly as it may cause the cedar to actually slip out of the ewe. The first thing we have to do is locate the vulva, which is here. We're then going to take our cedar applicator at a 30 degree angle. We've got to make sure we hold it flat in our hands so that when we insert it into the ewe, that it's going to come out horizontally with our wings. We slowly insert into the ewe, flush, and then we squeeze the handle and then remove the applicator. During the program, it's imperative that the cedar stays inside the ewe. We recommend that you do a daily morning and night check. Now, sometimes the tail end of the cedar will actually become less visible and you'll have to go in and check to make sure that it's still there. The removal of the cedar is quite simple. You first want to locate the end of the tail, pull directly out, and dispose in the waste basket. Now, we recommend that you do not reuse cedars, as its potential for disease transmission and program failures due to low progesterone levels in used cedars. Thanks again for watching our how-to video of inserting and removing cedars. If you have any additional questions, please feel free to contact us at Reproduction Specialty Group or find us online for additional videos and information. And don't forget to like us on Facebook.